Surely.
I am. What is it? I am serious, and don't call me something like that. And don't call me
Surely you can't be serious.
That's what it is.
I am serious, and don't call me Shirley.
Oh, did he die in 2016 or 2015?
2015.
Okay.
No, I was
so we don't have to blame 16 for him then.
Do you remember the scene where the chick's freaking out in the seat and like they're all like shaking? It's like, come, ma'am, calm down.
Oh, and then they have like a line form. It's a slapper.
I think they didn't they recently make that into a new meme because of United?
Yes, they did.
Oh, shit!
They saw that.
Oh, you have no idea how much United crap is on Facebook. I saw one where there's a guy who went to the Southwest customer service to complain about someone, a flight attendant, mistreating him. Like, yeah, I was treated horribly, called me fat and all this stuff. And he's like, I'm sorry, do you have a name for them? And he puts up a picture of the Britney Spears in her flight attendant outfit. Her name was Brittany. And then the person on the other end is like, oops, she did it again.
Oh, that's dumb.
Yeah. I thought that was wrong what they did. Like, they could have at least offered him, hey, you know.
They did offer.
Did they?
Apparently it was, based on what I've heard, it's anywhere from they were offering $400 to $1,000 and night's hotel fare for the people that would get off the flight.
Huh. I heard different.
So then why was this guy not doing it?
Yeah, why was he forcefully?
Because I didn't read anything about it.
Based
I
off
just
of what I've heard, they had employees who needed to be in the city that the plane was going to for a flight that was heading out the next day. So they were taking overbooked customers off the flight rather than not booking those seats to begin with, so their employees would have seats.
So it's United's fault then.
In the end, yes, it is their fault because they're going by the overbooking standard.
Well, that's the thing. Don't overbook. Like,
as a business thing, overbooking makes sense.
Yeah.
Because what they're doing is we have a plane that seats, let's just say, 1,000 people.
Okay.
And a lot of the time, people will get like stuck in traffic, last minute cancels, things like that. So if we book, say, 1,100 people on this flight, we have leeway in case 100 people don't show up for whatever reason, and we still have maximum usage out of our gas.
Okay, it makes sense, but
it makes sense as a business choice. It doesn't make sense as a customer satisfaction choice.
True.
Especially when they end up having to pull people off for their own employees rather than reserving seats for those employees to begin with.
Yeah, that just doesn't make sense. And, you know, it sucked that guy had to get dragged off of the plane and all that. But
oh, did you hear George Takei's response to it?
No, what did he say?
He was like, well, I guess they're taking old Asian men and beating them on planes now, so just make sure you have your cell phones down on my next trip.
wait, what?
So you know who George Takei is, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so he was like, so I guess they're taking old Asian men and beating them off planes now. Make sure you guys have your cell phones ready on my next trip.
Oh.
Dude, there were some things, apparently there's a mass wave in China of people cutting up their United rewards cards. So they pretty much lost an entire country out of it because they beat
big,
up an
though.
Asian
that is
man.
Big. Like, that's pretty much a chunk of your fucking, that's like 25% of your.
I mean, the guy already said he's got a couple lawyers and he's going to sue the shit out of them. So,
well, yeah, I mean, but then again, you got to remember these guys have lawyers too.
So from what you were saying, basically they overbooked.
Yeah.
And they were asking people, hey, if you volunteer to get off, we will put you up in a room, this and this and that.
Yeah.
And because the guy refused.
Well,
to
because
do
no
that,
one volunteered, from what I understand, they went to their computer and it randomly assigned so many people, like, take these people off. And he was one of those people, but he refused to get off.
I would do the same.
Agreed. I paid for this fucking seat.
I'm already
you have
sitting
no
in it.
Right to take me off.
Yeah.
Just because you're saying your employees have to be there. Well, guess what? I paid for this seat because I have to be there.
Yeah, it's like you're paying your employees pretty much to fucking go home. Like,
it's their responsibility to have their employees there.
Why not just put them in a better flight? Like, I don't know.
I don't know.
It's just fuck. Stupid.
It makes no sense to me. As a customer, I'm sure as a CEO with all your cost cutting bullshit in your head, it makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
But that's why I don't like the CEO mentality, because it completely negates the customer needs.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's all about efficiency and how to make the best amount of money while cutting the most costs.
It's all about that base, no trouble.
Are you done yet, Lane?
No.
I mean, we've been on this for a while, and you still haven't finished.
I get that, but it was that sniper up there that I had to figure out where he was. And I finally found out where he was. And I've been able to clear out this corridor of all these enemies.
Okay.
But there's a couple of invisible elites who have been sneaking up behind me, and I'm trying to figure out a way to prevent that.
So you don't want them to remove you from their seat?
No.
Come with us.
And that's the thing! They beat up a senior citizen!
Yeah.
Who the fuck beats up seniors?
Security.
Yeah.
Did you see the internal memo the CEO apparently sent to his employees?
Don't do this.
No, he was praising them, saying they did their jobs, and all employees were doing their jobs according to protocol and did it well. And he was being unruly, and that only security went a little too far. Right? Looked at that as like, idiot.
You're a dumb fuck, ain't ya?
I get that this is an internal email, but someone's gonna send that to the press, you idiot.
You know that one of your employees aren't going to agree with this, and you just send it to all of them.
Yeah. It's going to get out. And they don't care if they're fired.
Yeah.
Yeah, at that point...
If you disagree with your company that much, you're probably not caring if they fire you at that point.
Okay, I'm on Facebook right now, and it says, "Airline apologizes for strapping man to the roof of a plane due to oversold flight."
Oh, I love those, like, fake headlines they're making now for it.
Jesus.
It's so fucking... Yeah, this thing's gotten way out of hand. It's
the new Harambe for right now. Left.
There's one over there and there's one over there.
Yeah, trigger the one on the left
I'm
first.
I'm trying to. Fuck!
God damn you, Lane.
Shut up.
So fine in the other
Shut up.
Get your lawyers.
These aliens keep beating me in this corridor. Ow!
I don't think that's the word I would use if I was hit by a high-powered laser beam.
I don't know. Let's go ask Sergeant Johnson.
This article says, "All right, United Airlines, see and learn." What does that say?
Hang on. All right, United Airlines, see and learn. Etihad? Etihad Airways turned plane around for elderly couple to visit dying grandson.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know if I would do that as an airline.
Okay, so one of the ones that I had found at one point said that this was worse PR than the Pepsi commercial. Considering I haven't watched TV. I haven't watched TV in a long time, so I don't know about this Pepsi commercial. It's apparently with Kendall Jenner or whatever the fuck his name is.
Oh, yeah. To her.
Her? Okay. So, what's the deal with this commercial before...
Okay, do you want to... Does this have something to do with...
No, they're just saying that this United... it was like,
biggest thing since Pepsi.
Pepsi makes this horrible commercial. We can't get worse PR than this.
So basically,
United, hold my
beer. I didn't want to pause. Okay, so basically, Kendall Jenner, who is one of the Kardashians.
The Kardashian dad
That's Caitlyn.
Oh, okay.
Kendall is his daughter.
Okay.
Or her daughter.
Really, okay, gotcha.
Is Caitlyn's
daughter.
It's daughter. Hang on, another quick tangent, and I'll get right back on it. So you remember the Jake from State Farm commercials?
Oh God!
Someone made one where it was like, "Who are you talking to?" Oh, she sounds hideous, and it's Caitlyn Jenner. And,
God.
And the caption was, "Well, she's a dude, so."
That's horrible.
I know that was really offensive, but I thought it was funny. Anyway, so Kendall Jenner, the daughter of Caitlyn,
okay,
teamed up with Pepsi, and because of all like these police riots and shit in America and around the world, they basically did a thing where Kendall Jenner handed one of the police officers a Pepsi to help calm down the riot.
And, no.
Yeah. Wow.
That's not the point of the riots.
Yeah, so basically...
They're pretty much saying you could defuse a whole riot
with Pepsi. Yeah, Pepsi is a peace bringer. With
fucking Pepsi.
And so there's been like all kinds of boycotts against Pepsi.
Okay.
So
that makes more sense then, because there were things going around like, Pepsi did this commercial. Like, we can't possibly have worse PR than that. United, hold my beer.
Hold my Pepsi. Anyway. Hang on. Okay. Can I just say about that Kendall Pepsi commercial?
Okay.
The most offensive thing to me on that is that they used fucking Kendall Jenner. That is the most offensive part of that commercial to me.
I don't know. Okay, so I just saw this. Delta customers can now get up to 9,000. I call bullshit on that.
Well, from what I understand, and this is from someone who doesn't fly, if they tell you that your flight is overbooked and they're going to have to cancel your ticket before you get on the plane,
yeah,
they usually will offer you a same credit or cash, and that the cash value can be up to 4 or 5 times what your ticket value was.
Oh, okay.
So it's like,
another huge problem is that they told the guy on the plane.
They didn't figure it out before they started loading the plane up, which is weird.
That is so fucked up.
Yeah, it's just mind-boggling.
I mean, if it had been at the gate, he might have been more willing to take it. But by the time
he would have still been pissed. But at that
by the time my ass is in the seat on the plane, I'm not getting up again to get off.
But also, it also depends if that flight was if it was late and whatnot. What do you call it?
Oh,
delayed.
Delayed. Yeah. There you go. If it was delayed and he's been there for like 5 hours, fuck that. I want to go home. No, or whatever.
Well, he was apparently going to see patients because he's a doctor.
Yeah, he was a
doctor. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was a doctor.
Well, at least he knew how to treat his wounds.
Wow.
Yeah, dude, just that whole situation was all kinds of fucked.
Oh, there's fucking...
Oh, we'll see how well it goes for United.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see the lawsuit
settlement. Well,
their stock's
already fucking tanked.
Oh, yeah. They lost like $1.5 billion over a weekend over this.
Well, like you said, fucking Chinese people have been fucking tearing up their things.
A major transport hub in the world.
Yes, it's fucking... It's 1 billion. There's like 1 billion people there. Or how many people? Like 2 billion. I can't remember.
It's like 1.5 billion at this point.
Yeah. Like, it's a lot of customers.
Yeah. It's like, fuck, it's more than fucking half of the fucking country here. There's like a billion?
There's like 300 million people in America.
Yeah, see?
See what?
Don't fuck with the Asians.
Oh, man.
Well,
and then you have the whole Trump bombing Syria.
Yeah.
And then you have, did you hear about his interview where like he was talking about...
How he never makes mistakes?
He's not allowed to make mistakes. And then he makes a mistake.
Oh, yeah, that one. It was like, we never make mistakes. We're not allowed to make mistakes. Because if we make mistakes, people get hurt. All right, so here to talk more about this is, go ahead, Ken. My name is Gerald. He was talking to some reporter after the Syria thing happened. And he talked mostly about how...
What? I'm just thinking about that interview. I remember reading that.
The whole mistake thing? Or
no.
Oh, the one I'm talking about?
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Keep going on
so
that.
So basically, he was talking about like, oh yeah, we had this beautiful chocolate cake and the Chinese president was there, President Xi or whatever his name is. And we were having this great time. We're about to eat dinner. And the generals come up and they tell us that the ships are ready. The bombs are locked and loaded. And we're basically ready to go. And when we made the decision to drop the bombs. And we're eating this over this the most delicious chocolate cake you'll ever see in your life. And I told him, I said, President Xi, we just launched 59 missiles into Iraq. Wait.
you mean Syria. Yes, Syria.
Oh,
chocolate cake.
Fuck. Now, the whole thing was like they were talking about not even 60 seconds before he said that. He was talking about how President Obama fucked up in Iraq and like the war in Iraq with Bush and everything. And then he says Iraq right then. So a sympathizer could say something along the lines of he mixed it up because he just barely said Iraq.
Fine. Whatever.
Fine.
Okay.
But you're not allowed to make mistakes, Mr. President.
Oh,
I mean, especially after you just bombed them. I don't care if they're enemies or not.
While you're eating fucking chocolate cake.
I mean, fuck. They ruined the taste of the cake.
Maybe the people in it was the ISIS thing, wasn't it? Or
no, Syria.
No, Syria. It was
the Syrian rebels.
Was this,
so basically Syria.
No, but there's an ISIS thing now, too.
There's been an ISIS thing since
Obama. No, they bombed.
Don't take me all the way back. Oh, thank God.
They bombed an ISIS location.
Oh, yeah, they did. They did something, yeah.
I can't remember what it was.
It wasn't 59 missiles worth.
No, not 59, but...
I don't keep track of most political things anymore. Yeah. Lane, remember when you said this would never get political?
Jason made it so that we didn't have a choice. So yell at Jason for that.
No. How the hell?
Because how many times did I tell you to stop talking about Trump, Jason? How many times did I say shut up?
I didn't start this one, though.
Not this one, but now
we've gone from united to Trump.
Basically, you made it that you wouldn't listen to us. We begged you to not talk about Trump, but you wouldn't fucking ever shut up about it. So we said, fine, if he's not going to shut up, then I guess we'll get in on it, too. So, fuck
what if Trump.
Trump
wants to come in and play Halo co-op?
I'm the best at Halo. I am the best. Nobody
it's like
plays
chocolate cake.
Nobody plays Halo better than me. It's like when I go to the golf course. All right, I'm the best. I'm the best at golf.
I don't make mistakes.
You know, golf, Halo. Those are different. You know, those are different military alphabet terms. Actually, sir, the term is Halo.
Cortana. She got her hair idea from me.
Alpha, Beta, Cortana, you know how it is.
Yeah, these
fuck!
Jesus Christ!
Bullshit!
Kill that sniper!
Yes, he's dead. Where is he?
He's right there. So he's right in that little nook there.
Got him. I'm the best sniper.
Are you?
No. That's my buddy, Footy.
Does he just camp in games?
He can actually snipe people from a warthog. It's amazing.
Wow.
Oh, whoa!
Hey, at least you got a checkpoint there. You got a checkpoint right there. Now, don't go forward.
God!
Wow.
Was he behind me? No?
No, okay. He's right in front of you in that arch.
There you go.
There was a second one.
I didn't see that.
Where
one.
Is he?
No, they both. Because
the thing was that last time when he fired that shot at you, his round actually went by you before his body spawned in.
Oh, Halo 2. All right, where's the second asshole? I wanted to find the second.
No, he checked. Yeah, remember he checkpointed before the guy behind him died, so he's good now.
Oh.
Oh, is there someone behind you? Jesus Christ!
I'm fucked.
Kill that guy!
Hang on, you're gonna have to
get out of that alley.
Okay, where?
That's a good question.
No, there's no one behind you, dude.
No, there was a shot that went into the wall.
Yeah.
There is someone
back
there.
If I die right here, that's fine if I get to see where the shot came from.
That is a very good question, because there was someone behind you.
So I was watching a trailer on YouTube, and so you know how it's a thing now that wrestlers have become actors?
Sort of, yeah.
Okay, so there's this new movie with John Cena, and he's a sniper.
Oh, no. Okay.
Okay.
Is it anything like The Marine?
No.
Because didn't he make The Marine in response to Mark Wahlberg's The Sniper? Like, those movies came out, like, the same time.
Did they?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, obviously, the Marine won.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Piece of shit.
No, but I watched the trailer. He's a sniper with another sniper.
He's a sniper with another sniper.
Yeah, there's two snipers. One's the whatchamacallit?
Spotter.
The spotter and John Cena's a sniper.
Okay.
But they both snipe and they're.
I found the second sniper.
And the trailer goes on and John Cena's character ventures out to go check what's really going on down there, and there's a sniper they're looking for. And he snipes him, so then he's pinned down by the other sniper, and now there's two sniper or the two American snipers or whatever.
Uh-huh.
They're pinned down with this sniper, and they can't see where he's at. So now, like, I don't know.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jason, I'm going to be honest. You use the word sniper in there so many times, I'm confused.
Snipers.
So there's the snipers and there's the snippers. So the snipers go after the snippers who are around the bend trying to snipe them, trying to snipe the snipers. But the snippers don't like that. So
and they have the best chocolate cake.
That you'll ever taste.
It has my Trump gold flakes on it. The game despawned all of the extra weapons.
That's what you get for dying.
Oh, fuck me. Get up there.
Well, better make the best of what you got.
They got rid of everything!
Not everything. There's still some swords.
Ah.
Swords.
Swords. Nick Swartzen. Does he have a career anymore?
I haven't heard of him
in a long time.
I've heard of him. I haven't heard his name in a long time.
The last thing I heard him do was that fucking Grown Ups 2.
Well, there's your problem right there.
How many actors have lost their careers, including Adam Sandler,
because of Adam Sandler?
Yes.
Many.
I mean, fuck. Like, Adam Sandler has come out with, like, 3 new movies on Netflix in the last year and a half.
Isn't he trying to do the Jim Carrey thing where he goes to serious movies now?
Well, I know he's done, like, semi-serious ones.
Because Click was halfway decent, but it really wasn't a good movie.
True. It made me kind of tear up at the end. It was a sad concept. And then he did that one movie called, like, I think it was called Funny Guys.
Funny.
Funny People, yeah. And, like, oh, fuck you!
That's the guy who got you last time.
The part I love about that whole movie was the Eminem part.
You want to fuck me?
You want to fuck me, Ray Ramon?
I thought everybody loved you.
Ray Romano.
Yeah, that's it. I thought everyone loved you.
Well, Brad Garrett doesn't.
Oh, fucking Brad Garrett. No one likes you.
Jesus.
What are you doing, surprised. Jason?
I'm just going in the web.
Why?
For something to talk
He's
about.
Trying to find more United stuff.
Aww. God damn it. Okay, there was no... Fuck you. Fuck you. Ah, fuck.
God damn it.
Yeah, I killed him.
Fuck.
You couldn't even get through one level.
Not in an episode, no.
Why not? Speedrun, bitch.
Let's play speedrunners.
No.
No.
You don't deserve it. You can't speedrun.
We're like a speed walk.
Yeah. It's always good to know that even if you're blind firing, if you hear that, you hit something.
They should have one of those for every enemy type.
I know, right?
Could you imagine a hunter blowing up like that?
Yes! Yay! Oh my god, I want it.
Yay!
You killed it. Where'd it go?
All I hear.
At least you know if you're having a bad game, you can kill a few grunts and it makes you smile.
That's what this whole playthrough's been, I think.
Okay.
Apparently, Ryan Reynolds and Samuel Jackson are going to be starring in
the yes!
together.
Yes! Yes! I think I actually tagged you in that.
The Hitman's Body card.
Yeah, the Hitman's Body. I think I tagged you on that on Facebook, dude. Like a couple days ago.
Yeah, if Deadpool and Nick Fury met up.
Well, that's pretty much what it is.
Yeah, I think I tagged you on that on Facebook.
Trailer?
I did! It was funny!
was it?
It was funny, dude.
I gotta check it out afterwards.
Ryan Reynolds, now that he's embraced his inner Deadpool, seems much better off than he did as a Green Lantern.
Well, he's always been a funny actor. He's always been able to do comedic roles. Like fucking Van Wilder, dude. It was the last good National Lampoon movie.
Was it?
Well, I mean, okay, it wasn't good, but I rewatch it.
Lane!
Fuck, get past this level, damn it.
Get off your phone first.
I am. Why?
Because you've been on your phone this entire episode?
At the very least, Jason, find more United stuff.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Then look up hashtag United. Then you're not doing what you just said you were doing, Trump.
Fine, I'll fuck you. What?
I did not say I was looking for United stuff.
Cut back to 15 seconds ago. I'm looking for United stuff. Whoa, hello. Fuck. Okay, I need a new one. Thank you. Come on.
Ground pound. Ground pound.
Not in this game.
Ground pound.
You can wait when I put in Mass Effect later.
Ground pound. Ground pound.
Fuck you! I'm trying to avoid contact.
Oh, he contacted you. What'd you learn?
I did not mean to throw that.
Jason, have you seen the one where it's that yeah, where it's the video clip of God damn it, Jason.
All right, hang on. Okay, so United Airlines travel pillows, and it's the giant masks you put on when you're sparring and boxing.
Yeah, there was one where it's like a guy selling like those soft boxing helmets. For your next United flight, please remember your helmets. Are you enjoying this, Jason?
Oh, no, that laugh is never good. Welcome to United Airlines. How tough are you? It's a SpongeBob reference.
Welcome to the SpongeBob. How tough are you?
United Airlines is
nails for breakfast. Yes, so without any.
United Airlines is pleased to announce new seating on all domestic flights. In addition to United First and Economy Plus, we introduce Fight Club.
You're gonna have to send that to Tyler so he can put it up on the screen. Send it to Tyler so he can put it up on the screen, please.
I don't know if I can download it from fucking Instagram.
Screen cap it then.
Oh,
screen cap.
Okay.
Oh, for all you Call of Duty fans out there. Oh, Jesus. Chuck Norris traveled United once. The only seat rearranged was the captain's. Remember when we all liked Chuck Norris jokes?
I went to Maverick the other day. That's like our local gas like place.
I think Mavericks are kind of all over the country, dude.
Are they? Because I've never seen one in California. But anyways, they have this sponsorship. They're like Chuck Norris is like their fucking
It's like the new spokesman now or some shit.
And he was talking about this.
He's in his 70s, dude.
I know. He was talking about this new water that he came out with, and apparently it's so good that it turns you, like, you could look like an average Joe. It turns you into a fitness model, and then he pours it over his fucking, like, little fucking dinky-ass car, and it turns into, like, a fucking monster truck. I'm like, okay, hold on. This is pretty much kind of like fucking Michael Jordan's special fucking, his special stuff. From Space Jam, and he fucking gives them
special stuff.
Yeah,
I forgot all about that. Oh God, I don't like being sick.
But you love United.
Whoa, what the fuck? That was weird.
It's like your shield regened right there.
Yeah. Oh, I'm glad you saw that. Oh God damn.
So Jason, remember in. What was the third
Fuck
Batman
you.
Movie?
Fuck.
Tom Hanks.
Is now the Batman.
Third Batman one.
The Dark Knight Rises?
Dark Knight Rises. Remember where Bane was hijacking the plane?
Oh.
United Airlines security be like.
Oh my god!
We're gonna crash this plane.
United Airlines announces new marketing strategy, and it's Harrison Ford from
Get Air off Force. My plane.
Okay, you guys remember how Tom Hanks was in
Castaway?
Tom Hanks starring in Overbooked.
Oh god.
It's
god.
A picture of the it's a picture of the guy getting dragged off with fucking Tom Hanks' fucking face.
Have you seen the one where it's the Undertaker pile driving John Cena? United reaccommodating its passengers.
Welcome to the that was just so hilarious.
Lane, you're gonna have to keep an eye out for new South Park now, because that's gonna be a thing in like a week.
Oh, yeah. It absolutely will be. Why did I do that?
It's a very good question. I'm glad Jason enjoyed this.
Oh god. Oh fuck!
Fucking United.
Oh, that's fucking picture of Chris Brown.
Oh no. Hang on. Before you continue. Fuck. Is Rihanna anywhere in this picture?
No. But it's just Chris Brown, and it says, like, he's looking at his phone, and they, like, have a picture side by, like, right next to it, where it's, like, the front of the phone. And it says, Chris, it's United. We've seen your work, and we think you'd be a great fit. Call if you're interested.
Oh, wow.
That's so fucked up.
Let me check your United stock today. And it's gone.
Breaking news. Breaking news. Trump sends Kim Jong-un on a plane ticket to discuss his nuclear weapons program.
Oh my god.
He's on like a United Airlines fucking ticket.
No, Adrian! I made it on the plane!
Adrian!
Hang on. Okay, so I just...
God damn it!
Well, no, here's the thing, is that now we've hit the time for the episode, and we just hit a perfect place to pause, to stop, to go until next
time. Keep going.
Time. No,
just keep going.
Just keep going?
Forever.
Okay,
we
hang
can
on, before
keep
I
this
do,
going.
Before I do, I'm going to crack open a delicious Pepsi that the Jenner kid gave me. Oh.
So during an interview, there's a... So what are your qualifications? Gets punched in the face. Welcome to United.
I don't know who you are.
I want to see a Liam Neeson thing.
Oh, god damn it. Oh, I don't have any grenades and I'm out of plasma pistol.
That's okay.
Alright.
Yeah. So there's a picture of a UFC fight. Is just captioned, Ronda Rousey spotted after United flight.
Ooh.
I really like the Star Wars ones.
Yeah, those are all right.
Which ones?
Where you like the opening scenes of Star Wars where Darth Vader's walking onto the ship and he's holding up all of the rebel pilots.
Wow.
But my ticket says seat 16E. I am altering the deal.
Cocaine, marijuana, beer, dick. Oh, it shows the Asian dude.
United, we put the hospital in hospitality.
Wow. Wowzer.
Oh, my God. Oh, holy shit.
Are you going to have to put this up on the screen?
Oh, my God.
Tyler, put this up on the screen.
Let me see.
Oh. What? Are you okay?
Oh my god.
Here, go grab it. I can't see it. Go grab it.
Holy shit.
Okay. Oh no!
God. You get it. So I'll
Oh my god.
Let me preface this by saying I don't find these jokes funny.
Holy shit.
September 10th, 2001, World Trade Center refuses to move unrequested by United Airlines. September 11th, the picture. Yeah, don't put that. Don't
no,
put
that, that doesn't need to go up.
Don't put that on the
screen. That one's just step too far.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've never really found those ones funny.
Oh my god.
But a lot of people do for some reason.
I get that it's slightly clever, oh, but yeah, I guess it's not funny.
I see the humor in that picture.
Doesn't mean I find it funny.
Yeah. Oh, I just hit the mic hard. Sorry, everyone.
Wow.
Whew.
I just love that one. Welcome to United Airlines. Does it for you.
Why do I have two buttons to turn on my flashlight?
Do you?
Yeah, that's my directional pad. That's my X button.
Southwest Airlines, we beat our competitors, not you.
Yeah, right? Oh my god, Jason!
Is it bad?
Well, for us, no. For the rest of the world, maybe.
Oh! Jason!
He died for our seats.
My god!
Oh, that's so
horrible. Oh, we're going to hell! Oh, today's a good day to die.
Jesus Christ.
Let's call up United Airlines. Oh, you know what I just realized about that September 11th photo?
What?
What were the airlines used?
I don't know.
It was United, I think.
Was it really?
I don't know.
It was United.
If it was.
Because it was United, because they made a movie about it, United something.
United 53.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Something like that.
Oh my god, I think you're right.
Remember,
wow,
Jason, just don't ask United for a Pepsi.
Okay, so it's a picture of Bill Cosby.
That can't go good.
It just says, I could have tranquilized the passenger.
Oh. Oh, my God. Lane, have you gotten a checkpoint recently?
Yes, I'm at the checkpoint. I'm at the place where I said we should stop the
episode.
Did
it just checkpoint you?
It's been checkpointed. I keep dying in the same spot.
Okay, I think we can stop now.
Oh.
Next time, we'll try not to be as offensive.
Master Chief's hanging his head. We're going to hell. See you guys there.
Hey guys, if you want to see more videos like this, click on the Quacking Duck.
Or we also have more videos on the number 2 Yellow Dickie.
And if you want to be number 1 in our hearts, then click on the number 1 Quacking Duck.
Squat. Thrust. Oh, shit, I fell.